Well, trying to find me some dirt. And here in Texas, I get this color, and don't look great. And I get this color, which is black. Not good. I found one spot that I actually found some brown dirt, but it's kind of clumpy. Read some instructions, and it said to put it in the oven for 350 for an hour. So I got me three pans of this stuff, and I'll put it in there in the oven and kill all the stuff off from it. Then I'll run a magnet through it like it says and see what color sand I can get out of this for this thing. I did get some of this polyblend non-sanded grout, and the color I got there was linen. So that's a little darker than this, but they said all this stuff darkens up, so even if this darkens up a little bit, that'll be fine for over here. Okay, let's get this stuff in the oven. I've been tweaking on this thing all weekend with this sculpted mold, reshaping some of this areas that I like to have shaped better, and it just didn't come out the way I wanted with the paper and the cloth. So I shaped it a little bit better. It actually stiffens it up pretty good. I've reshaped the corner over there. I've reshaped up around the pond and the pond area. I've reshaped. I'm gonna continue tweaking with that until I get it where I want it, and then I'll go to painting. I did buy some different paint, and I'll cover that in a little bit. What I'm gonna do in the meantime is I'm going to jump ahead a little bit, and it says to put the cloth on here on the sides. So I'm going to go ahead and do that here and I'm going to try to get everything on this start to cure up and get dry. But I'm going to go ahead and do the sides. And if you go to do one yourself and you look at it, I got a little bit of a bulge. I don't know if that's okay. Maybe I pushed paper in there too tight and it's bulging out a little bit. It ain't terrible, but I ain't going to worry about it. The back side, it does a little bit bulge there in the middle, a little bit, but not too terrible. This side seems to be worse. I must have pushed out on it a little bit. I ain't gonna sweat that. But my big questions was it says overlap at 1 inch, so I'm gonna bring it up to incorporate the cloth over the edge an inch here, and I'm only gonna take it down to wood level. I'm not putting it down over the wood. So an inch up over the top and to the edge on the bottom. And I'm gonna pin all those sheets up and I'll get back with you. Well, I got one sheet up here and I'm gonna use the spray bottle method. And it's pinned up there, and then I'll do another layer, then I'll do the top one. I'm just gonna do one at a time here. Got a little overlap on this side so I can make those corners a little tighter. And I'll show you when I'm done. Okay, got the other side taken care of. It's all pinned down. I trimmed me about an inch off the top. Kind of give me an inch to go over all the way around. It's all done. It's all cut in. And one thing I'll tell you, better latch a couple hours to do these sides. Doesn't appear to be that hard, but it does. It does, and they weren't kidding. It does make a mess. So I didn't lay down anything like it told me to, and now I get to pay the price. I get to clean up behind it. But it does look like it's sealed the top end pretty good. I overlapped it a little bit all the way around the edge, and now I'm gonna probably come back and do some more on that, clean it up a little bit. But right now I think we're gonna let it chill for a little bit, let it dry. I think it's some of this mess cleaned up around here. And Well, I've been kind of all over the place with this thing. I do know this much. I jumped the gun on the color. I did jump the gun on the color. So what I'm going to do is I went back over and I fixed every place that I didn't like using the sculpted mold. Sculpt the mold and 3 pound bag, and I still got about a half a pound left in there. But I went through and fixed all the spots that I didn't like, make sure all my rocks are in good. I'm fixing the edges. I'm gonna get it again. I jumped the gun, so I'm gonna get all this base and the color of the rocks done. And then the other thing I did was I noticed that there was a cutout here when I was doing the sides, and it was for the road to come out, but there was no road coming out there. I'd moved the road going out the other side, so I chopped out this side, did a little fix on it. Can't really tell, ain't no big deal anyway. Fixed the front, cut a piece, put it in there, so now my road does go out to the side. It was like roadblock there. And I have all the paint that I'm gonna do this with when I'm satisfied with the shape of everything and make sure that all the holes are filled and this thing's sealed. I'm probably gonna sculpt a mold around this whole edge just so it's sealed up and hard all the way around. And again, I'm gonna work the whole base, and then I'll get back with you, show you the end result. And then I went to Walmart and I bought some paints, and this was the color that looked to be the closest. This is the color that looked to be the closest to fawn. So I bought 6 or 7 of these. I think 8 of them actually. And I'm going to paint the whole thing like it says to do, the whole thing in this color right here. And Luke Towan, when he paints, it wasn't looking like this. It looked like it was actually painted that color. So that's what I'm gonna do. And the other thing that I've been getting into is dirt. I wasted a good couple days trying to get some dirt. And then I found some other dirt, and it was more tan. But I had to bring the big clobs of dirt back, and it says to throw them in the oven for 350 for an hour. And if you know what dirt makes in an hour in the oven, it makes rocks. So I had to add some water back in after all the germs and stuff were killed out of it. Add some water back in, then dry it out again, smoosh it up, and then I use this little deal right here, the Hamilton Beach food processor on it. And I went and bought the sifter and sifted it down, so I got some dirt to go along with 50-50 with my grout. And I think I'll have a color here that'll work. I think it'll be fine. Well, got a little jump on the painting. I finally was satisfied with the edge, how this sculpt a mold worked around this edge. Everything looks good and cleaned up. I went over every bit of this, and I may have missed a little bit, but I got it looking where I want to go. So I started with the paint. I'm gonna insert a picture up here of this Luke Towan thing. And you know, the color, is it close? I think it's pretty close. It's fawn. This was actually called, the one I'm using is light mocha. And it was pretty close. And you know what, once you get some dirt down on top of it and over the whole thing, I think it's irrelevant what color it is, to tell you the truth. But I am going to put down this color down over the whole thing, and get all this thing covered up. And as I'm painting, I find areas that I need to square away. I'll take care of it. But just painting in around the rocks, and didn't get real close. I think I'm gonna go to airbrush, and this one I just didn't get real close to the rock itself. Because I'm probably gonna touch up these rocks with a little airbrush action. I got the color on the whole thing now, and I didn't get real close in around the rocks, but I just recolored the rocks a little bit with a little black, light black wash. I may do it again, but I gotta, now I'm gonna go in and tighten up all of the around all the rocks here with a smaller paintbrush, get those cleaned up. Maybe, still don't like all this little holes. I guess it's not really gonna make a big difference, but I don't wanna see it. I just don't really wanna see it. All these areas is not gonna matter underneath here. But if it's out in the open, yeah, I think I'm gonna just keep putting paint on it until it goes away. Not looking too awful shabby right now, and it's been sturdy. Paint actually helps sturdy it up a little. Every time I put something on there, it sturdies it up a little bit better. Okay, moving on.